I would like to thank the Hall of Fame for this great honor. I am humbled to be in this amazing class. I also want to thank Calvin and Akeem for once again standing by my side. You are both very important to me. Calvin, during my playing days, you were my teammate, my roommate, my neighbor, my best friend, and most of all, my brother. And we shared so many experiences together. It means so much to me that you are here to share this with me. Hakeem, you more than anyone are responsible for me being here. You were the best player to ever wear a Houston Rockets jersey and one of the best of all time. A team doesn't win unless the coach has the best players' cooperation, but you gave us much more than that. You gave us your excellence, your leadership, and your big heart. And you taught me something very valuable, the importance of spirituality in all phases of my life. Thank you. And I stand here today because of the way you and your teammates played, how you did it together as a team. With your backs against the wall, you won 8 elimination games to bring 2 championships to the city of Houston. I love and respect all of you. Now, every player made sacrifices, but 2 awesome players, they sacrificed more. And that was Kenny Smith and Otis Thorpe for putting up with my substitution patterns. I know you guys didn't like it. No one would. Yet you came and you played hard every minute you were on the floor. And you are what being a champion is all about. You have my utmost respect and admiration. I want to thank Clyde Drexler for keeping the boat afloat that second year, then being the superstar that he is to help us win our second ring. I want to thank Mad Max, Vernon Maxwell, for being a warrior. I want to thank Carl Herrera for coming up big against New York. I want to thank Sam Cassell for having big cojones. I want to thank Mario Elie for being a good kisser, especially from the left corner. I want to thank owners Charlie Thomas and Leslie Alexander for giving me the opportunity to coach these special players. I want to thank the fans for their undying support. We couldn't have done it without you. When thousands showed up at the airport in the middle of the night to urge us on, we couldn't let you deal. We couldn't let you down. I feel your spirit right here, Houston. I want to thank my parents. We didn't have much as far as material things, but I felt well loved. I want to thank my sweet sister, Fran, who always gives me unconditional love and support. I want to thank my Uncle Joe for teaching me all the sports, and my cousin, Mark, for showing me how to handle success and staying humble. I fell in love with basketball the first time I saw it. And as a young boy, I carved into my headboard of my bed, I love basketball. And I went to sleep with my hand on that carving, and I dreamed of one day getting to the NBA. After today, I can say that my life turned out better than my wildest dreams. Sometimes when the fathers are chasing their dreams, the children suffer. But my three children, Nicole, Melissa, and Trey, have turned out to be truly wonderful, caring people. I am so proud of them and my grandchildren. I cannot take credit for them. It all goes to Sophie T., who passed down her wonderful qualities to them. I owe so much to the game of basketball. It has given me a very rich life. Now, please understand, I'm not talking about money. I'm talking about something more valuable than money, like great relationships and incredible memories. Basketball has given me so many gifts. Beside my champions, I got the opportunity to coach some of the greatest players of all time. The great Kobe Bryant. Who thrilled us for 20 years right down to the last game. Kevin Garnett, who helped us bring home the gold in 2000. I had Charles Barkley for 2 years in Houston. He's the most unselfish player I've ever had. I got to coach the great Yao Ming. So big, so talented, so humble. Different personalities from different places, from all corners of the world. Commissioner David Stern did a tremendous job making basketball a global game. He passed the baton to Adam Silver, who continues to expand that vision. The NBA is in great hands with Adam. I have traveled the world because of basketball. I had the honor of representing our country in 1998 in the World Games in Greece, and then in 2000, the Olympics in Australia. I was there when Vince Carter jumped over the Eiffel Tower. I want to thank USA Basketball for those unforgettable experiences. Jim Tooley, Sean Ford, Russ Granick, Rod Thorne, and Jerry Colangelo, thank you. I came into basketball with no brothers. Today I have many. Basketball has given me a big brother in Carol Dawson, my assistant coach, then general manager of the Rockets. He passed on so much knowledge to me, I couldn't have done it without him. To my other brothers, assistant coaches Larry Smith, Bill Berry, Jim Boylan, Dean Cooper, Melvin Hunt, and Mike Wells, with you guys by my side, I felt we could conquer the world, and we did. To Robert Barr, you've always had my back. I miss you. Let's hang. To Dennis Lindsay, thank you for everything. Your success with the Utah Jazz is no surprise to me. To John Killalay, Joe Ash, Gianluca Pascucci, and BJ Johnson, I wish you were here, BJ. I want to thank Phil Fischera and Jesse Brown for taking care of business. I want to thank general managers Pete Newell, Ray Patterson, Steve Patterson, and Bob Weinauer. I want to thank Bill Worrell, Gene Peterson, Jim Foley, Matt Bullard, Tim Frank, and Joel Blank. Thanks to James Haywood, Butch, Chip, and Chirp. I want to thank the coaches who influenced me, Tex Winter, for teaching me the importance of terminology. Del Harris, who taught me how to think outside the box. Don Chaney, on how to teach the rotating defense. Bill Fitch, on how to make key adjustments. And I really want to thank the brotherhood of coaches who spoke up for me the past few years. Greg Popovich. Jeff Van Gundy, Doc Rivers, Scotty Brooks, Mike D'Antoni, and Eric Spoelstra. Guys, you made me feel like a million bucks. And in that spirit, I want to speak up for Robert Horry to be inducted into the Hall of Fame. He is truly a legendary player. He made so many clutch shots. He's got 7 rings to prove it. This is where he belongs. I want to thank the Los Angeles Lakers and the Buss family and the Minnesota Timberwolves and Gerson Rojas for giving me an opportunity to be of service to them. I want to thank my teammates from the University of Michigan for being here. Go Blue! I want to thank my old friends and my new friends from Austin for coming here to support me. I want to thank James from the neighborhood back in Hamtramck, the Dequindre Jets. And last but not least, I want to thank my beautiful sweetheart, Lisa, for keeping me healthy, happy, and grateful, and for reminding me every day of how blessed we are. Thank you very much.